Let us start with the refraction using Huygens principle. Yesterday we did reflection of light using Huygens principle. So using Huygens principles, we had drawn the reflected wavefront CD first of all. And this in case of refraction also, we had drawn this CD refracted wavefront using Huygens principles. I repeat Huygens principles once. Every point on primary wavefront acts as a fresh source of new disturbances called secondary wavelets that propagate in all the directions with speed of light. Then with CT as radius and each point of disturbance at the center, we draw the spheres. So second postulate says that a forward tangential envelope drawn to the spheres gives the location of secondary wavefront at any point. So in this case, these are our incident rays. Okay, incident on a surface that is able to bend the rays of light. So that is the refracting surface we have taken. And with normal angle of incidence is I, and wavefront is always perpendicular to the rays of light. So AB is our incident wavefront. This is our primary wavefront. Okay. AB is our primary wavefront. And we are to find what? We are to find refracted wavefront CD using this. Okay, so CD is our refracted wavefront. So if a wavelet travels from B to C after covering a distance V1T, because these are two different media, one and two. So BC distance is equal to V1T, speed into time. And with V2T distance, we draw an arc from A point and draw that tangentially to C point, and this way we get the refracted wavefront CD. So in this case, AD is V2T. Our AD is V2T here. So BC is V1T and AD is V2T. If this is angle of incidence, angle between these two lines will also be angle of incidence, kyunki ye dono lines in dono ke perpendicular. Same way, if these are refracted rays and this is angle of refraction, so ye wala angle bhi R hoga. You can easily make out. Now, how we can justify refraction using Huygens principles if we are able to prove Snell's law? So let us prove that. For Snell's law, we need sine I and sine R. So we can make use of these triangles to calculate sine I and sine R. So let us first of all take triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, what is sine I? Ray and wavefront are perpendicular. So this is the 90 degree angle here. So sine I can be written as perpendicular BC over hypotenuse AC. BC upon AC. In triangle ADC, sine R will be perpendicular AD over hypotenuse AC. AD over AC. So first of all, we have written sine I and sine R. We have written sine I and sine R first of all. Okay. Then divide sine I by sine R. VC by AC, AC by AD. We divide and then we put in the values of BC and AD. BC is V1T, AD is V2T. Are all these steps clear to you? Varun, you were present yesterday, so aapko pata hoga ki humne ye kaise banaya tha, diagram kaise banaya tha using Huygens principle. Okay, and how we found the refracted wavefront CD using Huygens principle. तो डायग्राम हमने बनाया हुआ है, बस मैंने आगे स्टार्ट किया है क्योंकि वी आर गोइंग टू प्रूव स्नेल्स लॉ. इफ वी वांट टू प्रूव रिफ्रैक्शन यूजिंग हाइगन्स प्रिंसिपल्स, सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम स्नेल्स लॉ. वी वांट टू प्रूव दैट. सो फॉर स्नेल्स लॉ यू नीड साइन आई एंड साइन आर. सो वी आर मेकिंग यूज ऑफ दीज टू ट्राइंगल्स. इन ट्राइंगल एबीसी वी फाइंड साइन आई, इन ट्राइंगल एडीसी वी फाइंड साइन आर. सो साइन आई इज बीसी ओवर एसी. Sin R is perpendicular over hypotenuse, AD over AC. So then we divide the both, sin I over sin R. you know, AC gets cancelled and we are left with BC over AD. We have written here BC kya tha? Secondary wavelet yahan se yahan tak travel kar rahi thi from incident to refracted wavefront. So this was equal to distance V1T and AD was equal to V2T. In the second medium, it travels lesser distance because let us assume that second medium is denser. So that's why the speed of light will be different in that medium. We have taken two media, one and two. So in second medium, the speed of light is different. Up to here, I think this is clear to you. Then we cancel out T and we are having V1 over V2. We use a step now. Let us multiply and divide right hand side by C, speed of light in the air. Multiply and divide right hand side by C, the speed of light in the air. Now we can also write this thing as C over V2 over C over V1. It doesn't make any difference. If we have V1 over V2 into C by C, can't we write it as C over V2 over C over V1? That is automatically equal to V1 over V2. So this is another way of writing V1 over V2. C over V2 over C over V1. Now what is C by V? Who will tell me? C by V kiska formula hai?
Mu.
Mu. Yes, very good. So mu is equal to C by V. Accordingly, we can write C by V2 as mu2 and C by V1 mu1. Now what is mu2 over mu1? Relative refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. So we started from sin I over sin r and C we have got mu. So which is Snell's law? So using Huygens principles, we have proved Snell's law. We have proved refraction using Snell's law. So this is the answer and very, very important question this is. Okay, reflection using Huygens principle, refraction using Huygens principle. Usually in board question, this was asked for 3 marks. So this is very important article. You must do the written practice. So Huygens principles are over. Our next wave phenomena. In this unit, there are 3 new wave phenomena in wave optics. Interference of light, diffraction of light and polarization of light. Polarization of light is not in our syllabus. So we'll be doing interference of light and diffraction of light that you have never done before. In plus one in waves chapter, we did some interference of general waves. But now specifically in case of light, we will be discussing the interference. So ye entirely new phenomenon hai jo aapne pehle nahi padha hua. Right? So if you have done this, let us move on to interference of light. But before that, we need to know few terms. First term is coherent sources. And a reminder, tomorrow you are having test from ray optics at 4 o'clock. So there is very important term, coherent sources. What are coherent sources? These are the sources that emit waves of same frequency, same wavelength. Okay? Frequency bhi same hai, wavelength bhi same hai. Amplitude same hona koi zaruri nahi. Amplitude may or may not be the same. And the most important condition is phase difference is 0 degree. They have same phase also. Theek hai? So what are coherent sources? These are the sources that emit waves of same frequency, same wavelength and same phase or constant phase difference. Agar phase same nahi hai, to at least phase difference constant. All right. So write the definition of coherent sources. The sources that emit waves of same frequency, same wavelength, same phase or constant phase difference. The sources that emit waves of same frequency, same wavelength, same phase or constant phase difference. और कांस्टेंट फेज डिफरेंस, तो वो कोहरेंट सोर्सेज होते हैं. एंड फॉर दिस इंटरफेरेंस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी ऑलवेज नीड कोहरेंट सोर्सेज. बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ कोहरेंट सोर्सेज इज टू लेजर लाइट्स. टू लेजर लाइट, सपोज वी आर यूजिंग टॉय रेड लेजर लाइट, देन देयर विल बी कोहरेंट सोर्सेज बिकॉज द लाइट एमिटेड फ्रॉम देम विल बी ऑफ सेम वेवलेंथ, सेम फ्रिक्वेंसी, एंड कॉन्स्टेंट फेज डिफरेंस विल बी देयर बिटवीन देम. यू नो लेजर बीम, लेजर बीम इज हाईली intense unidirectional and monochromatic beam of light. Okay, so laser is based on stimulated emission of radiation. That's why all the photons, they are in constant phase, they are not having any phase difference. Their phase difference is 0 degree. Constant phase is there. Okay, so coherent sources are needed here. So ek practical example I have told you ki hum do laser light use kar sakte hain. ठीक है, यू विल फाइंड कॉमनली दिस क्वेश्चन इन द बुक्स दैट टू बल्ब्स ऑफ आइडेंटिकल वॉटेज कैन दे बी यूज्ड टू प्रोड्यूस इंटरफेरेंस पैटर्न. सो आवर आंसर विल बी नो. टू बल्ब्स वेदर दे आर हैविंग आइडेंटिकल वॉटेज, वो सेम वॉटेज के हों, ठीक है, उनका फ्रिक्वेंसी वेवलेंथ मे बी सेम, बट ये जो थर्ड कंडीशन है ना फेज डिफरेंस वाली, वो सेम नहीं होगी टू बल्ब्स के लिए. ठीक है, दिस कंडीशन विल नेवर बी मेट. So that's why we can't use two identical bulbs for carrying out interference experiment, but we can use two laser lights for conducting this kind of experiment. Another example is of coherent sources, that is Lloyd's mirror and Fresnel's biprism. Two examples of coherent sources are Lloyd's mirror and Fresnel's biprism. Now, what is in case of Lloyd's mirror, source and its virtual image, they act like coherent sources. Of course, source ki jo image hogi wo bilkul usi ke jaisi hogi, identical hogi. So, in Lloyd's mirror, ek to source hota hai, dusri uski virtual image hoti hai. They act like coherent sources. And in Fresnel's biprism, एक ही सोर्स की दो वर्चुअल इमेजेस, दे एक्ट लाइक कोहरेंट सोर्स. ठीक है, यू कैन नोट इट डाउन. मैं ज्यादा इसको एलैबोरेट नहीं करना चाहती, रे डायग्राम वगैरह बना के कैसे उसकी इमेज बनती है इतने डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. ठीक है, बट आप नोट कर लो कि इसमें कौन से सोर्सेज होते हैं. Fresnel's biprism में टू वर्चुअल इमेजेस ऑफ द सेम सोर्स, ऑफकोर्स वो आइडेंटिकल होंगे, they can act like coherent sources. Okay, so in Lloyd's mirror, source and its virtual image will act like coherent sources, and in Fresnel's biprism, two virtual images of the same source will act like coherent sources. Then second term that we need to know before interference, that is superposition. Ye humne plus one mein bhi kiya tha, if you remember. Principle of superposition of waves. Principle of superposition. Suppose there is a particle in a medium and a number of independent waves are passing through that medium. Then that particle will get displaced. ठीक है? Resultant displacement of a particle due to number of independent waves is the vector sum of individual displacements. This is principle of superposition. It is not their algebraic sum, it is vector sum of individual displacement. What does it mean? It means that what direction the waves are approaching. Okay, what is the direction of a wave? That is very important. If the waves are moving in the same direction, then this displacement will be more. If the waves are moving in the opposite direction, then displacement will be less, and so on. Okay, so it depends upon direction in which the waves are propagating. That is very important here. So write down the statement of principle of superposition. Resultant displacement of a particle due to a number of independent waves propagating in a medium. Resultant displacement of a particle of a medium due to a number of waves propagating in a medium is the vector sum of individual displacement. Is the vector sum of individual displacements, that is vector y is equal to vector y1 plus y2, so on. There are two types of superpositions. Depending upon the direction of waves, there are two types of superposition: constructive superposition and destructive superposition. So constructive superposition means when two waves are approaching in such a way that crest of one falls on crest of other. You know, light wave is transverse in nature. It is having two parts, crest and trough. So this is y1, suppose, this is y2, suppose. So there are two waves, they are approaching in such a direction that crest of one falls on crest of other, trough of one falls on trough of other. Okay. Then the resultant displacement will be the sum of individual displacement. Y will be equal to y1 plus y2. This kind of superposition will be constructive. This kind of superposition will be constructive. So superposition is said to be constructive if two waves are propagating in the same direction, in the same phase, such that crest of one falls on crest of other and trough of one falls on trough of other. Okay, such that amplitudes get added up, or resultant displacement is the sum of individual displacement. So this kind of superposition will be constructive superposition. And destructive, if the waves are approaching in the opposite manner. ये y1 है और ये second wave है जिसका phase 180 degree out of phase है ये. Both are moving in opposite direction such that trough of one, crest of one falls on trough of other and vice versa. अब resultant amplitude, resultant displacement इन दोनों का subtraction होगा, because you can easily see bigger minus smaller. So this will be your resultant wave. And amplitude of resulting wave in this case will be y1 minus y2. This type of superposition is called destructive superposition. So we are doing these terms because we are going to use these terms in interference as well as diffraction of light. So I hope both the terms are clear to you. Coherent sources kya hote hain and what is superposition and what do we mean by constructive superposition and what do we mean by destructive superposition. So that means when two light waves, they superimpose constructively, the resultant intensity at that place will be more than the intensity of individual light waves. And when they are meeting destructively, then the light, resultant light intensity at that place will be less than the intensity of individual waves. That means we will have bright patches in this case of constructive superposition, and we will have dark patches of light in case of destructive superposition. The patches of light, they are called fringes. Here we will be using this term fringes for the patches of light obtained. They will be called fringes. Yahan tak koi doubt students pooch sakte ho aap? If there is any doubt, you can ask. No doubt? देख लो एक बारी, दोनों टर्म्स क्लियर है. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट. एंड यंग वाज अ साइंटिस्ट हु डिड द एक्सपेरिमेंट, यंग्स डबल स्लिट एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस यंग्स डबल स्लिट एक्सपेरिमेंट. ठीक है, चलिए लेट अस गेट द हेडिंग. Young's double slit experiment, we call it YDSE. So we call it YDSE, Young's double slit experiment. So what did Young do? Thomas Young. He again was a supporter of wave nature of light. I told you yesterday that different scientists, they come forward with their different theories regarding the nature of light. Somebody was saying that light has particle nature. Someone was saying that light has wave nature. Okay, so ultimately dual nature of matter was predicted. Dual nature of light was predicted in the end. But what were the contributions towards wave theory we are discussing? So Thomas Young, he was also a strong contender, and he also proved wave theory, wave nature of light. So he had taken two slits, S1 and S2. He had taken two slits illuminated by a single source of light. So usne ek single source liya aur two slits ko usse illuminate karwaya. So they also started emitting identical waves. So that's why these two slits acted like coherent sources. Ek hi source inko illuminate kar raha hai, to isliye ye bilkul identical waves emit karenge. So he had taken double slit as coherent sources. Now from this source waves are originating. We are showing one crest and one trough. क्रेस्ट को मैं सॉलिड लाइन से शो कर रही हूं और ट्रफ को डॉटेड लाइन से शो कर रही हूं. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो डू लाइक दैट और यू कैन यूज टू पेन्स ऑफ डिफरेंट कलर. सो क्रेस्ट ट्रफ दिस वे द वेव्स आर प्रोपेगेटिंग फ्रॉम दिस सोर्स एंड व्हेन दे रीच द स्लिट स्लिट्स ऑल्सो स्टार्ट प्रोड्यूसिंग क्रेस्ट एंड ट्रफ्स इन द सेम वे. दिस इज क्रेस्ट. This is trough, crest. Almost equal distance पे बनाते जाइए. Crest, trough. एक का बना लो पहले. एक slit को center पे रख के पहले आप ये pattern draw करो. Then we will do for the second slit as well. ठीक है. नाउ सेकेंड स्लिट. अब इसको भी सेंटर में रख के बनाते जाइए. रेगुलर इंटरवल्स पे बनाते जाइए लाइक दिस. ठीक है, जितने बनाने हैं बना लो. सो देयर इज अ स्क्रीन हियर. देयर इज अ स्क्रीन केप्ट हियर जस्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ द स्क्रीन. इफ यू लुक बिल्कुल इन दोनों स्लिट्स के सेंटर में अगर आप देखो तो यू विल सी डॉटेड लाइंस आर इंटरसेक्टिंग एंड सॉलिड लाइंस आर इंटरसेक्टिंग इनके बिल्कुल सामने. तो इसका मतलब कंस्ट्रक्टिव सुपरपोजिशन हो रही है. And this will be the location of a bright fringe. एक bright patch of light हमें center पे नजर आएगा screen पे because of constructive superposition happening. बिल्कुल दोनों slit के center में आप देखोगे कि trough को cross कर रही है और crest को कर रही है. इसका मतलब बिल्कुल center पे constructive superposition हो रहा है. And जहां पे crest trough को cross कर रही है वहां पे dark patch of light, dark fringe नजर आएगा. So this way, when you draw, ये approximately आप draw कर लीजिए. ये देखिए ये crest trough को cross कर रही है. यहाँ पे dark patch आ गया. ये accordingly बना लीजिए. ये dark patch आ गया. So you will see alternate bright and dark patches of light will be seen. Alternate bright and dark patches of light will be seen on the screen. This pattern is called interference pattern. that is obtained on the screen. So this is bright fringe and this is dark fringe. Alternate bright and dark fringes of light will be obtained on the screen, and this pattern will be called interference pattern. So this was Young's double slit experiment. Okay. Now what were various observations? We'll be doing the mathematical portion also. We'll be deriving conditions for constructive and destructive interference also. कि कब एक ब्राइट पैच आता है, उसकी कंडीशन क्या है, कब एक डार्क पैच हमें ऑब्जर्व होगा, उसकी कंडीशन क्या है, एंड सो ऑन. बट यू हैव अ लुक एट द डायग्राम फर्स्ट. इफ इट इज क्लियर देन वी विल मूव ऑन टू द डेरिवेशन. यस, एनी डाउट फ्रॉम द डायग्राम, एनी डाउट फ्रॉम द पैटर्न, हाउ डार्क एंड लाइट, डार्क एंड ब्राइट पैचेज आर फॉर्म, fringes are obtained. Is that clear to you? Any doubts regarding this? You can ask.
बता दो मैम, ये एक बार बता दो कि डार्क कैसे बने और ब्राइट कैसे बने.
आपने पैटर्न बना लिया पहले, तो ऑलमोस्ट
यस मैम,
स्क्रीन के सेंटर में आप देखोगे, ये देखो दो डॉटेड लाइंस क्रॉस कर रही है, यहाँ पे दो सॉलिड लाइंस क्रॉस कर रही है, बिल्कुल ऑलमोस्ट सेंटर के पास आप देखोगे, अगर आपने बिल्कुल इक्वल डिस्टेंस लेके बनाया, तो इसका मतलब क्रेस्ट पे, ट्रफ पे फॉल कर रही है, तो इसके ऑपोजिट हमने एक ब्राइट पैच बना दिया. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पे देखिए, ये सॉलिड लाइन है या डॉटेड लाइन है, ये इसको क्रॉस कर रही है, डिस्ट्रक्टिव सुपरपोजिशन हो रहा है बिकॉज क्रेस्ट इज फॉलिंग ऑन ट्रफ, तो यहाँ पे इसका कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग आई हैव ड्रॉन डार्क पैच. तो इस तरह से जब आप बनाओगे तो यू विल सी ऑल्टरनेट ब्राइट एंड डार्क पैचेस ऑन द स्क्रीन. दिस पैटर्न विल बी इंटरफेरेंस पैटर्न. If we do this experiment with the help of two toy laser lights, ठीक है, उनको हम interfere करवाएं, तो screen पे हमें alternate bright और dark spots of light नजर आएंगे. That pattern will be called interference pattern. ठीक है, गितेश, is that clear?
मैम ये cool. चमकने वाला कौन सा fringe होगा, dark या bright?
ब्राइट फ्रिंज जो है वो ब्राइट होगा, मतलब वहां पे इंटेंसिटी की लाइट ज्यादा होगी, लाइट की इंटेंसिटी, और डार्क फ्रिंज मतलब वो डार्क होगा. और अगर बेस्ट कंट्रास्ट है, इफ वी टेक द एम्पलीट्यूड्स ऑफ बोथ द वेव सेम, तो बेस्ट कंट्रास्ट विल बी देयर, द ब्राइट फ्रिंजेस विल बी परफेक्टली ब्राइट एंड डार्क फ्रिंजेस विल बी परफेक्टली डार्क, मतलब आपको वहां पे डार्कनेस दिखेगी, वहां पे लाइट इंटेंसिटी का स्पॉट भी नजर नहीं आएगा, डार्क फ्रिंजेस के प्लेस पे बिल्कुल डार्कनेस होगी, आपको सिर्फ स्क्रीन पे कहीं कहीं रेड रेड कलर के ब्राइट स्पॉट नजर आएंगे, वो सारे ब्राइट होंगे, इसका मतलब आपको डार्क दिख ही नहीं रही है. ठीक है, अदरवाइज अगर हम एक यूजुअल पैटर्न लें जिसमें इंटेंस एम्पलीट्यूड अनइक्वल थे दोनों लेजर लाइट्स के, तो हमें कहीं पे ज्यादा ब्राइट स्पॉट, कहीं पे कम लाइट स्पॉट, इस तरह से नजर आएंगे. ठीक है, लाइट हर प्लेस पे दिखेगी, बट कहीं पे ज्यादा होगी उसको ब्राइट फ्रिंज कहेंगे, कहीं पे कम होगा, डिम होगा वो, उसको हम डार्क फ्रिंज बोलेंगे. बेस्ट कंट्रास्ट तब होगा जब दोनों इंटरफेरिंग वेव्स के एम्पलीट्यूड हम सेम लेते हैं, तब बेस्ट कंट्रास्ट होगा. राइट,
ओके मैम,
ओके. सो लेट अस नाउ डू अ डेरिवेशन, कंडीशंस फॉर कंस्ट्रक्टिव एंड डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस. ओके, ये बहुत मैटर करता है कि क्या कंडीशंस है, कब बनेंगे ये पैचेस. तो कंडीशंस फॉर कंस्ट्रक्टिव एंड डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट. Conditions for constructive and destructive interference. So let us say that first wave, amplitude of first wave, displacement of first wave can be written as A sine omega t, and second wave can be written as B sine omega t plus phi. Why I have written omega t plus phi? Where phi is constant phase difference between two waves. क्योंकि ये हमारी condition थी. इंटरफेरेंस पैटर्न तभी प्रोड्यूस होगा if there is a constant phase difference between two waves. So phi is that constant phase difference. अगर एक का फेज ओमेगा टी टी लिया है तो दूसरे का ओमेगा टी प्लस फाइव ओमेगा टी माइनस फाइव लेंगे. तो यहाँ पे तीन चीजें हमारी कॉन्स्टेंट्स हैं, गिवन है ए एंड बी, एम्पलीट्यूड्स ऑफ बोथ द वेव्स जो हमने अभी डिफरेंट लिए हैं, एंड फाइव विच इज द कॉन्स्टेंट फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन द वेव्स एज पर अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर कंडीशन. अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन or according to principle of superposition, y equal to y1 plus y2, resultant displacement is the sum of individual displacements, put the values of both. So y is a sine omega t plus b sine omega t plus phi. Now we are to solve this. सेकेंड टर्म में साइन ए प्लस बी को हम क्या लिखेंगे, साइन ए कॉस बी प्लस कॉस ए साइन बी. ठीक है, यू नो दैट. सो लेट अस राइट सो ए साइन ओमेगा टी प्लस बी साइन ए cos b plus cos a sin b. Sin a plus b we have applied. Sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Now see, in two terms you have sin omega t. So let us take sin omega t common now. A plus B cos phi sin omega t plus B sin phi cos omega. What we have done, why we have written these things in bracket? क्योंकि आपको बताया था कि A, B और phi constants हैं. So we have taken constant in bracket. A plus B cos phi इधर आ गया और B sin phi constant हमारा इधर आ गया. And we have kept both the things in bracket. See, these steps are clear. कोई डाउट पहले यहां तक. Yes, any doubt? चलिए अब in say this is equation number one, put simplification के लिए a plus b cos phi equal to a cos theta. And let us put b sin phi equal to a sin theta. Where what is capital A and theta? These are amplitude and phase of resultant wave as a result of superposition. ठीक है, जो हमारी resulting wave बन रही है उसके amplitude और phase की terms में convert करने के लिए we make b substitute. See this step. Let us call this equation number 2 and this equation number 3. Okay, equation number 2 and equation number 3. Dekh lo ek bari. Aapko likh ke practice karni padegi iski. So let us substitute these equations in one. You get y is equal to a cos theta sin omega t plus a sin theta cos omega t. देखो कैसे की substitution. A common and writing like this, sin omega t cos theta plus cos omega t sin theta. Isn't it sin a plus b? So this is sin omega t plus theta. So this is the equation of resulting wave as a result of superposition, which is in terms of resultant amplitude and phase of resultant wave. पर फिर भी ये इक्वेशन हमारे लिए इतनी इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है जितनी की इक्वेशन नंबर 2 and 3. पर फिर भी इसको नोट करके रख लीजिए कि ये रिजल्टेंट वेव की इक्वेशन है आपकी. राइट, वी विल मेनली फोकस ऑन इक्वेशन नंबर 2 and 3 दैट वी यूज फॉर सब्स्टिट्यूशन. उनसे आगे
मैं
हमारा
फॉर्मूला लिखा दो,
मेन फॉर्मूला आएगा। हाँ जी
ट्रिग्नोमेट्री का फॉर्मूला लिखवा दो मैम को।
हाँ फॉर्मूला लिखो,
लगा
हमने यूज किया साइन ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू साइन ए कॉस बी प्लस कॉस ए साइन बी। वी हैव यूज दिस फॉर्मूला एट टू प्लेसेस, एक यहाँ पे पुट किया था, एक यहाँ यूज किया, तो यही सेम फॉर्मूला, ठीक है, दो प्लेसेस पे हमने यही फॉर्मूला यूज किया, ठीक है।